We've lost Dale Earnhardt.
The day NASCAR lost Dale Earnhardt, February 18, 2001, will forever loom as the day the NASCAR culture changed. In the 11 years preceding Earnhardt's death, 9 drivers died during NASCAR National Series races. In the 2 decades since, the sport remarkably has not suffered a single driver fatality at a major NASCAR race. 0 deaths in 20 years, despite horrific accidents such as Ryan Newman's crash in the 2020 Daytona 500. What changed? Nearly everything about NASCAR's and its drivers' approach to safety. Why? Because the sport's Superman died. In response to Earnhardt's death, NASCAR... The day NASCAR lost Dale Earnhardt, February 18, 2001, created an Earnhardt legacy that everybody wishes never happened, but also goes down in history as its most important mark on the sport. NASCAR's superhero perished and sparked a revolution. Earnhardt's death to challenge stubborn drivers' long-held bravado towards safety. Like Ricky Craven told me, we lost an icon. In the eyes of so many, Dale Earnhardt was larger than life. Craven even once said to himself, if Dale Earnhardt could die in a race car, we're f***ed. Earnhardt carried an unprecedented stature in the sport. The working-class fans worshipped the son of a mill worker. He had the ear of NASCAR leadership. He possessed brilliant marketing instincts, developing a fierce and fearless persona that drove NASCAR's merchandise sales. Most of all, he won, especially at Daytona. Earnhardt, NASCAR's 8th winningest driver of all time, treated Daytona as his personal playground, winning a record 34 races there across various series. As Earnhardt's son, Dale Earnhardt Jr. said, there's a lot of fans that ain't quite recovered from that loss. And he's right.
It wasn't like nobody, everybody saying, you know, there's no problem. It wasn't that. It was, okay, let's do the math, let's do the science, let's think through this. Let's not just, you know, make a knee-jerk reaction. But I think enough of the homework had been done that when Dale's accident happened, it was, okay, we've got some things in the work, we need to implement it right away.
In the summer after Earnhardt's death, before NASCAR released its investigation to the public, NASCAR showed drivers footage of actual racing wrecks using crash test dummies plus in-car camera footage that demonstrated how much the head moved inside the car. Still, it would take time and consistent effort to alter the sport's daredevil culture. One source of resistance came from drivers who had already tried new ideas, such as the Heinz device. He gave it mixed reviews. Despite initial resistance,